Hey guys, Eric Biggie Bartoldus here from Yoshimura. Today, Vital MX is visiting and we're just gonna talk about the new RS12 exhaust system that we have just released for the RMZ450. It's a all new system that we're super proud of. And there's a lot of features and benefits that go with the RS12 that we're really just trying to take the exhaust game up a notch to just really increase performance and longevity, really just have an overall better exhaust system. So we've been in development with this system for well over 2 years. It really started off on the RCH Yoshimura Suzuki team. Brock Tickle and Vogel were using this. And our idea was, you know, we're changing so many things on the exhaust system. We really wanted to have a lot of developed in the heat of competition, making sure that this thing works for the highest level. And then we can bring these elements down into the RS12. So it's been a long time coming. Obviously, you guys have probably seen it out there for the last 3 years or so, but it's here. It's for the RMZ 450. I think in the next week or so, really soon, we're going to be releasing the RMZ 250, and then other models will follow with the RS12, and the RS4 will eventually, over the next few years, just fade away, and the RS12 will replace that. So the first feature you'll see is really the kind of the asymmetrical shape of the profile of the exhaust. Everything is for a reason, really, for this muffler. So it's really flat on this side. We wanted to maximize tire clearance on this side. And then on this side, it's round. Well, we're still trying to keep enough volume into the system as we can. More volume means a quieter exhaust and longevity and actually more performance because we're able to put more packing in. And then on the bottom, you'll see it's kind of chiseled. It's got a kind of chiseled bottom. And that's for, you know, we've been noticing on a lot of on our RS4 systems for really, really aggressive riders that are doing some gnarly seat bouncing techniques. The brake caliper was hitting the canister, so we've incorporated that feature into the shape of the muffler. The next thing you'll see is it's got a really unique carbon fiber end cap. It's a matte finish on it. We wanted to kind of really keep a cool stealth look to it. And you'll see too on the end cap that it actually has a really flat shape where the decals are. So this shape is basically like putting a sticker on a helmet. It's got a double curve to it. So when you're applying stickers to it, it's really hard to keep that shape and not have the stickers come up. So we wanted to incorporate places for the sticker to go and keep, and what we did is we have an aluminum back sticker here so it withstands the high temperatures of the heat coming through the carbon cap. The next thing we've done is this has a design feature much like the RS9 where the cap is actually more of a decorative piece on the end of it, where the RS4 was part of the structure of the unit. So the RS4, the cap actually went into the end canister. This is basically goes on the outside of the end cap, and it keeps the structure. If you have you get in a first turn crash or something happens where your end cap's compromised, this thing can go away and you're not gonna have a catastrophic failure in the heat of racing. Okay, so another thing we've done is this insert. It's a PTF, it's a precision taper fit. So you'll see on the end here, there's a really nice machine finish on the inside. There's about an eighth inch of engagement, which is really all you need on this. And it just fits in together super nice. And it just pops right in there and you just put the end, the bolt in, it holds it on. So obviously when this is on, the bolt inserts through the end cap. And I think one of the big things that we're really excited about too for the RS12 is we're gonna go with machine joints instead of a slip fit. And what a machine joint does, you'll see on this piece here, this is a perfectly round machined coupler on the end of this. This one doesn't have that. This is a rolled tube. So what you get is 50% better engagement, and it's a lot better going together. It fits a lot tighter. You get a more consistent fit. You're not gonna have to be fighting with your bike to get your exhaust system apart. It'll just come apart just like that easy. That's the idea. So that's one of the things that we've had to really adjust for here internally is making that precision fit across in production. The piece comes with hard anodized washers. And even one thing that we've been testing too is this new grommet. Sounds like a trivial thing, but this grommet is actually made of a material called Viton. And Viton is a high temp material that doesn't break down and crumble. Because that's one of the things we've noticed in our grommets recently is as they get hot, they break down and they crumble and you have to replace them often. This new material is gonna last a lot longer. And it's just another one of those things, those details, we wanted to really try to put everything we can into the new RS12.
My name is Eric Steen. I'm the R&D manager here at Yoshimura. So you can see behind me here, we've got the ferro arm and our 3D scan. So we have the ability to completely scan the bike so we have a 3D model. This helps us when we're doing design so that we don't have to physically design the parts on the bike. We can design it in CAD first. And the end result here, you can see, we can test for all the design features. We can see the caliper clearance, we can see the position of the muffler, make sure that there's tire clearance, and this is all done before we make any sort of physical prototype. And that speeds up the design process and ensures that when the product is produced, it fits up right the first time, every time.
So again, the idea with the RS12 is it'll come out as we develop new systems for new bikes. The RS4 will still be around for a while, but eventually, again, it will phase out and will be the new PTF, the precision taper fit, will be incorporated into all the new systems. So be on the lookout for it. Again, RMZ 450 is out now. 250 will come out really, really soon. I think the next bike we'll have is the YZ250, and that'll probably be towards the end of January, February sometime. And then as we release more models, obviously you'll see here on Vital NX. So thanks for stopping by Vital NX.